Alors, me voici de retour, finalement. C'est classique. Well, it's the classic. So maybe I should stay in bed today, by the way. So, we continue. We hope that the others will join and then, well, we'll continue the lesson as we started it. And so we were about to work together on the verb of the day. So obviously we've been falling from 89% to 12, so you'll have to work a lot, I mean the persons who are there. So the thing is that for the verb of the day, of course we're talking about the conjugation. So normally when we talk about an advanced level, we should basically master all these tenses. So, three moods: indicatif, conditionnel, and then subjonctif. And four distances usually should be mastered if you want to reach this advanced, so B2 level. Okay, so in our case today, we will work on the verb choisir. D'accord? So, the verb choisir is a regular verb from the second group. So you can see that it ends with ER. So remember that not all the verbs ending with ER belong to the second group, but this one does and is regular. So let's have a look, because in our situation, we will, well, let's say that we will now focus on présent, futur simple, and passé composé for today. So let's start with the présent, and could you please give me je, tu, il and elle for the present of our verb, and the verb was choisir. Luciana, rebonjour Ice Cubes, I managed to restart the stream. Sorry about that. So we agreed that when we're talking about the verb choisir in the present tense, then in that case it will be je choisis, so ES, tu choisis, ES, and then il, elle choisit, IT. Remember, you will pronounce them exactly the same way, but still you write them quite differently. Don't forget the ES at the end of je, d'accord? It's exactly the same form, je and tu, d'accord? Donc je choisis, tu choisis, il, elle choisit. Could you give me, please, nous, vous, il, elle, for the same verb choisir in the present?
Thank you.
Alors, let's have a look now. And this is the tricky thing in that case, because I'm looking at what you're writing. Remember that it will be ils sont. So first you will have your root, and in that case, after that, you will put the ils sont. So choise and then ils sont. Nous choisissons. So it's a tricky one to pronounce. Nous choisissons. Then vous choisissez, d'accord? And the last one, il and elle choisissent. So remember the endings as usually. So O-N-S for nous. E-Z for vous. And then E-N-T for il, elle in the plural form. Remember, you write it, but you don't pronounce the E-N-T. D'accord? So now let's have a look at the futur simple. Same thing, we'll work with je, tu, il, and elle. Futur simple of choisir. Alors, in that case, the way to construct it will be quite simple, in fact, because you will just use your infinitive form, choisir, so it will be your root, your stem. And after that, you will just add the endings for the futur simple. So remember, for je, it will be ai, je choisirai. For tu, it will be as, tu choisiras. And then for il, elle, it will be a, il choisira, elle choisira. Okay, so je choisirai, tu choisiras, il choisira, elle choisira. Allez, give me nous, vous, il and elle for choisir in the futur simple. Alors, same concept here, we will keep exactly the same root. The root will be the infinitive, so choisir, and after that we will put the endings. So, as we know, O-N-S is the classic ending of nous, so nous choisirons. E-Z is the classic ending for vous, vous choisirez. And then O-N-T will be the ending in the futur simple for il, elle of the plural. Ils choisiront, elles choisiront. Okay? Brostache is joining us. Bonjour, Brostache. You can join and enjoy the lesson. Let's hope I won't have any technical problem, but we never know. Allez, nous choisirons, vous choisirez, ils choisiront, elles choisiront. So look now, passé composé, so passé, passé composé, still the verb choisir, je, tu, il, elle. I am waiting for you. Alors, in that situation, choisir, of course, you need to understand that passé composé is a compound tense. So it means that we will use a helping verb, whether it will be avoir or then être. And choisir, like most of the verbs, will use avoir. So we'll use avoir here, the present tense, j'ai. And after that, you will put your past participle. The past participle form of choisir will be choisi. Keep in mind that all the verbs from the second group, like this one ending with ir, will have their past participle ending with i. So choisir, choisi, finir, fini, unir, uni, etc., etc. So j'ai choisi, tu a choisi, so same concept, hein, you use the verb avoir in that case, in the present form, tu as. And then il a choisi, elle a choisi. D'accord? Let's have a look at choisir, passé composé, nous, vous, il and elle, s'il vous plaît. Alors, we continue with the same logic. In fact, we agree that now we are using avoir. Avoir should be conjugated in the present tense. So, nous avons, and then choisi, the past participle that doesn't change, even if it's the plural. Remember that with avoir, you never put anything at the end of your past participle that is related to the subject. So, nous avons choisi. I. Vous avez choisi I. Ils ont choisi I. Elles ont choisi I. D'accord? Donc, well, that's it. That's it for the conjugaison. And I'm still traumatized. Traumatized by the technical problem that we had. Et oui! Allez, let's continue. And it's the picture of the day. So please, please write me a simple sentence to describe this photo. Thank you. Alors, Annabelle Nouvelle est la première. You're the first one to write. J'aurais toujours quelque chose à donner. Wow, it's really nice and nicely written. Merci beaucoup. Mr. Peter, le pigeon a beaucoup faim. Ouais, on peut aussi utiliser très. Il a très faim. And remember, Mr. Peter, beaucoup, you write it B-E-A-U, hein, C-O-U-P. Luciana, l'oiseau mange sur la main de cet homme. Oui, the expression is dans la main, dans la main. Et cet homme, remember, you should write cet, C-E-T. Arkitoun, un homme gentil, nourrit, avec un T, un oiseau. Très bien, Stéphanie, un oiseau mange sur la paume d'un homme. D'accord. Bourmville lover, un oiseau attaque une personne. You think that you really think he's attacking the person? Maybe. Be careful, because person is feminine. Whether you're talking about a man or a woman, person is a feminine word. Donc une personne. Cajal, il y a un oiseau masculin qui mange dans la main. D'accord. Sarah, la photo dépeint un oiseau qui mange dans la main de l'homme. Oui, l'unique, la photo est d'un oiseau masculin qui mange un morceau de nourriture. La nourriture est dans la main de l'homme. Très bien. Mujahid, ils ont dit il vaut mieux donner. Ben c'est vrai, hein, surtout que ça fait peur si on ne donne pas. Ice Cubes, je vois un oiseau affamé et une main. Ah, c'est une description très claire. Sundar, je vois la personne qui donne un grain à un pigeon. Ok. Daria, sur cette belle photo, on voit un oiseau et une main d'une personne qui aime la nature et les oiseaux, avec un X au pluriel d'oiseau. Et en tendant la main, il nourrit cet oiseau. Attention, Daria, oiseau masculin, 7 C-E. Lovina, la confiance est une vertu précieuse. L'oiseau fait confiance à la main et la main fait confiance à l'oiseau. Waouh, c'est très très joli ça. C'est très joli. Alors ensuite, qu'est-ce qu'il y avait ? Il y avait Ouria, il y a un oiseau qui mange au bras, peut-être à la main. Hein, pas tellement le bras, mais à la main. Sapna, un oiseau en train de manger la nourriture et un homme offre la nourriture pour ou à manger. Oui. Oiseau, d'accord, you've been writing it correctly. Save the best, l'oiseau mange sa nourriture. Très bien. Victoria Posse, peut-être un pigeon, un oiseau ou une mouette féminin. Une qui mange de la main de quelqu'un ou de quelques personnes. Quelqu'un, it's enough, so you don't need to put personne. Vous n'avez pas besoin de mettre personne, Victoria Posse. Mohana, les oiseaux et les animaux ont le droit de vivre dans ce monde comme nous. Veillez aimer la nature pour les protéger comme cet homme. Très bien. Sonia, une personne nourrissant un oiseau. Très bien, Sonia. Ensuite, alors attendez, je regarde. I just called. Il y a un oiseau qui mange d'une main de l'homme. Ice Cubes, oui, je suis sans espoir aujourd'hui. Merci. Bah, Ice Cubes, look at me. Look at me. I'm not even able to plug my computer and it mess up the whole stream. There are just days like that. It happens. Allez. So the three nouns of the day. Look at this picture or photo and find three nouns. Only nouns. I don't want verbs, if that's possible. I just would like to have nouns. And of course, I would like you to put the article just to see if it's masculine or feminine. Thank you. somebody is the first one to to write, and it's les arbres. Très, très bien écrit. Les arbres. So agree that arbre is masculine, by the way, even if you don't look it, see it like that. Cajal, les personnes, les arbres, les rues. Très bien. Ouais. Est-ce que c'est des rues ou des passages? Je ne sais pas. L'unique, les arbres, un vélo et des personnes, d'accord. Un arbre, un pont, dit Ouria, très bien. Luciana, les gens, les arbres, les ponts, très bien. Sundar, les personnes, des étages, des arbres, oui. Lovina, un vélo, un jardin, un étage. Be careful, Lovina, vélo is masculine, un vélo. Daria, un fauteuil roulant, masculin, les chaussures à crampons, pas de E, O-N-S, les ponts. Sarah, une plateforme, des personnes, des arbres, très bien. Victoria, des arbres, des ponts, merci. Stéphanie, alors des légumes, des herbes et des gaps. I'm not sure what you want to say with gap exactly. Not sure about that. Alors, somebody. Des gens marchent sur la route ou sur le pont, d'accord. Architoun, des étages. Victoria Jacques, des ponts. Sapna nous dit la rue ou les rues, des gens, des arbres. Et Sarah nous dit des plateformes et il y en a plusieurs. Allez, let's continue with the dictation of the day. As you know, we will have four sentences and then I will read them. You will have to write them. Let's start with the first one. So I will read them twice. Nous lui avons dit de ne pas venir. Nous lui avons dit de ne pas venir. So write the sentence, please. Alors, I can see that I just called was the first one and it was really well written. So I'm looking at your sentences. Hein? So in that case, I wanted you to put, well, obviously, the verb dire in the passé composé, nous avons dit. Okay. And after that, well, of course, as usually, I like to squeeze some pronouns. So the pronoun lui, pronom complément d'objet indirect, should be before your helping verb, so avoir. Nous lui avons dit. And after that, of course, the verb dire, it will be conjugated or it will be, sorry, structured with the preposition de when you introduce another verb. So, nous lui avons dit de venir. And now the tricky thing, keep in mind that when you want to put the negative form for an infinitive verb, in that case you will put ne pas in front of the infinitive. So you don't do it like normally we should put the ne, then the verb, and after the pas. Non, when it's a negative form of an infinitive, ne pas will be before the infinitive. So that's the reason why I wanted to put that here. Nous lui avons dit, and then de ne pas venir. So the negation is connecting to venir. D'accord? So this is the way it goes. Let's have a look now at, well, the second sentence. Si vous pouviez le faire, virgule, ce serait formidable. Si vous pouviez le faire, virgule, ce serait formidable. Alors, let's have a look at your sentences. It seems that it's actually quite good. So we agree that I wanted here to introduce a structure with si, and then followed by the imparfait tense. Si vous pouviez. Hein, pouviez is the imparfait form of the verb pouvoir. And so remember that the way to structure it will be quite strict, in fact. If you start with si, with imparfait, it means that in the rest of your sentence, so the second verb will be automatically in the conditionnel présent form. So ce, serait should be definitely the conditionnel présent, so s-e-r-a-i-t. Ok, si vous pouviez le faire, ce serait formidable. Manang Singh is saying, salut, welcome to the lesson, Manang Singh. We're doing some dictation, so you can participate. Alors, one more time, si vous pouviez le faire, ce serait formidable. So let's have a look now at the third sentence. Listen carefully and write it. N'hésitez pas à prendre des risques. N'hésitez pas à prendre des risques. Alors, let's have a look at the sentence. Annabelle Nouvelle is going to bed. Good night. Must be late. Hein? Allez, and sweet dreams. So look at the sentence. The sentence is, n'hésitez pas à prendre des risques. So I wanted to, in that case, introduce the imperative form. So n'hésitez pas. Because as you can see, you don't have any subject in that case. Huh? So, but then it's exactly the same form as for the present. So, n'hésitez, you write it with a Z in the end. After that, you will have the second part of the negative form, so pas. And after that, à prendre des risques. Hein? N'hésitez pas à prendre des risques. So be careful because I'm looking at Uria. Yeah, Uria, you didn't get the first verb and then you thought it was apprendre, hein, but it's a and then after that it's the verb prendre. D'accord? N'hésitez pas à prendre des risques. Look at the last one for today. Je lui ai préparé une tarte aux pommes. Je lui ai préparé une tarte aux pomme. Rory, normally if you look at the sentences, I am translating them all the time, and in that case, prendre des risques, it's to take risks, d'accord? So just look at that. For the beginners and the intermediate courses, I always put translations when I think it's necessary, d'accord? Alors, in that case, if you look carefully, I wanted to go for this, the passé composé form one more time. J'ai préparé. So remember, préparé, regular verb. It means that you will have to use the helping verb avoir. J'ai préparé. And of course, I wanted to put a pronoun, and the pronoun, as we know now, it should be before your helping verb. Je lui ai préparé. And then, une tarte. And as you can see, it's O. So it should be the plural form, A-U-X. And then, pomme should be also in the plural, P-O-M-M-E-S. Because normally you've got more than one. Je lui ai préparé une tarte aux pommes. Alors, I know that you are enthusiastic, and when we start to make it, it's always like, I don't really have the time to explain that to everybody. So, let's agree on that, and I will explain the way it works for the others. So, the idea will be simple. I will write on my notepad, which I have here, a number from 1 to 100. So don't start to put it now, please. Then you will try to guess this number, and you will have only one possibility. So you will give first one number. And the winner will get, well, in that case, it's not the beginners, but you will get an access for the intermediate package that I've got on my platform. So let's do it like that. Voilà. So it looks a bit more clean. So, and I really hope that you're ready for that. So, of course, now we will start, and you can start to put your numbers. So far, nobody, yeah, but Joao has been writing too many numbers. So unfortunately, Joao, I mean, you don't qualify. You've been putting too many numbers. So now I invite you to write a second round of number because you didn't find it yet. And Joao, unfortunately, it won't be for today, so it can be for tomorrow. Thank you. So how is it possible? Nobody finds my number today. Yesterday it was so fast, and today nobody find my number. I am really sad. So I don't know. I mean, we should try one more round. So please make me another suggestion. Thank you. Astroéki. Astroéki, are you here? Astroéki, well, thank you very much to find my number because Astroéki found 17 and my number it was 17. My number was 17. So Astroéki, I'm really happy for you. So you will win the intermediate package and please, please, please let us be nice with Astroéki and congratulate him or her. I don't know if it's him or her, but still Astroéki, félicitations. Alors, est-ce qui? Oh, Barbara. Très bien. Félicitations, Barbara. So, Barbara, the way to do, you will go to my platform, frenchforme.net. Then you just register on the platform. You send me a message through the platform. And then after that, I will give you access to the course that you just won. Félicitations, Barbara. Félicitations. We are really happy for you. At least we didn't have any technical problem for the little game. Allez, à quoi pense-t-elle? À quoi pense cette jeune demoiselle? So write me a sentence to just imagine what she has in mind right now. Alors, Kajal Malik, elle pense que lorsque les vaccins pour le Covid seront, ok, you should put the future, the plural form, seront, S-E-R-O-N-T, and then disponible, you should put the plural form too, because you've been putting les vaccins, so with an S in the end. Bourmville Lover, elle pense pourquoi ses mains sont sur mon visage. C'est possible. Mr. Peter, elle pense « Oh, je suis trop jolie pour ce monde !» C'est possible. Victoria Posse, je ne sais pas ce que je vais faire après les cours de Vincent. Ah, il faut se reposer, il faut se reposer. Sarah, elle est pensive. Très bien écrit, Sarah. Lovina, quand ce shoot sera-t-il terminé? Ah, pour les photos. Patricia, l'hiver arrive et nous ne pouvons pas voyager. Ben oui, elle a l'air triste. Daria, elle pense que la vie était cruelle et injuste et elle a l'air d'être triste, mais le photographe remonte son moral. Très bien. Attention, Daria, moral, you don't have a in the end, ok? Moral, le moral, the mood, the spirit, la morale, with a in the end, it's the moral. Faites attention, hein. Alors, Yana, choquée et contente, très bien. Lunik, elle pense à quel dommage, d'accord? Mais quel dommage, pourquoi? Rita, Assor, elle pense comment conserver ma beauté? C'est possible. Sarah, elle pense à son mari. Oui, alors c'est avec A, Sarah. Remember, you've got to put the preposition A. Shinoshino, qui est la plus belle au monde? Rory, elle pense pourquoi elle ne gagne pas et pourquoi le nombre de Vincent est 17. Well, Rory, I've been picking 17 because it was the birthday of my son, 17, and it's coming soon because it's in 4 days, by the way. That's the simple reason. Uria, elle pense à comment elle a perdu le jeu. Elle est triste. Mohana, elle se demande pourquoi cuisiner ce soir. Ah, elle se demande quoi cuisiner ce soir. Bickert, elle pense, je suis très belle, je suis jeune, comme toujours, d'accord. Kajal, d'accord. Mujahid, elle pense à son prochain paiement de voiture, comme moi. D'accord. Est-ce qu'elle a une grosse voiture ou pas? On ne sait pas, Mujahid. Irène, elle pense comment elle peut gagner à la loterie. Eh oui. Sundar, elle pense que la vie est difficile. Ice Cubes, il pleut beaucoup dehors cet été et elle est passée. Ah, elle a passé le temps derrière la fenêtre. Ouais, derrière avec un E. Sapna, elle pense à quelques poses qu'elle doit poser pour obtenir une photo magique pour ce magazine. Très bien. Sarah, merci, je corrige. Elle pense à son mari. Mais très très bien. Merci beaucoup en tout cas. Allez, the tip of the day. As you know, I like to ask you some questions regarding the way you learn French. And now it's how do you motivate yourself to continue to study French? So it's a question. So how do you find the motivation? Because we know that when we start to study something, sometimes we lose the motivation. Sometimes it's not as simple. Maybe there are some topics that are a bit more difficult. How do you manage to motivate yourself, to continue learn and study French? Allez, you can write in French and you can write, of course, in English too. No worries about that. And yes, even if we had some technical difficulties, remember to be nice with me and like. Alors, Lunik is the first one, and Lunik says, if I don't quit, I won't fail, which is a good motivation. Kajal, quand je pense à ce que je vais gagner si j'apprends le français. Ok. Luciana, une de mes motivations est de regarder tes leçons. Province. Oh, merci, Luciana. you're nice. Rory, bon, je rêve de rencontrer bientôt mon amant francophone. Ah, ben ça, c'est une bonne motivation. Ça, c'est une très bonne motivation, Rory. Et il faut parler français. Il faut parler français avec votre amant. Daria, malheureusement, parfois, quand je commence à apprendre quelque chose de nouveau, et après, je quitte, mais je me rends compte que c'est nécessaire de travailler systématiquement. Sinon, on ne peut pas progresser. Il faut travailler. Eh bien, c'est vrai, Daria. Donc, vous êtes raisonnable. Vous avez compris comment ça marche. Alors, Boomville Lover, I watch your video games video as I can laugh and I still learn at the same time. But it's better when my son is playing the video games, because if I'm playing, I mean, you can learn words, but clearly it's not really interesting to watch. Sundar, quand je regarde des films français avec les sous-titres, je comprends beaucoup, donc ça me motive beaucoup. Oui, ça c'est bien. Sarah, maintenant je participe à des groupes de meet-up et de conversations. Récemment, j'ai trouvé un partenaire pour la langue pour échanger. Je je l'assiste avec l'anglais et elle parle français avec moi. Yep, it can work quite well, this teach one hein, concept. Ça, c'est bien. Be curt, je me dis, mon espoir ne doit pas être perdu. Petit à petit, je progresserai en français. Be curt, I saw the progress hein, when you write. I mean, it's quite clear since we started together. I mean, so you can continue like that. Levina. Je dis à tous mes amis quand je vais essayer quelque chose, this way I make it public and I hate to fail publicly. It's a good way, in fact. It's a good way because people will ask you, so how is it going for your thing? And so you won't have to admit that you stopped. Olga, I just feel the need to study and learn, especially French. Okay, so you don't feel that sometimes it's too difficult and you want to give up. And it's a good thing, Olga. Yesero, je pense à tous les endroits où je peux voyager et toutes les personnes avec qui je peux parler. Très bien. Sarah, je peux comprendre l'oral plus facilement, mais c'est difficile pour parler et écrire. Sarah, it's totally normal. It is totally normal. The fact that you can understand oral French is really good. It's really good because it means that, in fact, it won't be a problem to produce orally and to start to talk. So no worries about that. Production is always more difficult than understanding. So don't worry about that. It's just a question of time. Irène, je crois que la discipline. Ensuite, j'essaye d'apprendre le français tous les jours. Après ça, je peux visiter et apprendre en France. Oui. Sapna, quand je réussis de temps en temps avec les examens de français, je suis automatiquement motivé. Très bien. Victoria Jacques, my motivation becoming more comfortable speaking French with now will help when I live in France one day. Yes, you will. This class refreshes my memory and helps me to learn something new every single class. Oh, merci Victoria. Ice Cubes, bonne question. Je me motive pour avoir des personnes pour pratiquer la langue régulièrement ou quelqu'un qui est intéressé d'apprendre cette langue. Très bien. Mohana, quand je détourne de mes études ce que je fais, je sors écouter de la musique et je me dis que je peux le faire plusieurs fois. Parfois, je dors pour être fraîche. Parisien, salut Vincent, salut Parisien. Mujahid, merely to understand, they want to comment it like they're cracking some funny jokes. Ok. Allez, on continue. And we will finish with this little and simple exercise because look, I want you to feel good and to translate me these simple words. So, what is a house in French? Alors, Evil Wizard just joined us. Salut, you can participate to the thing, but it's the end of the stream now. So, a house, it's une maison. Let's agree that it should be feminine. So, I guess that's, I mean, so far so good. We can go fast. The number two, a car. Could you give me the French word for a car, please? it's une voiture. Ice Cube saying that the house, it's un château pour moi. So remember, Ice Cube, château, it's masculine. Now it's une voiture or la voiture. We agree. So the next one is a phone. What is a phone in French? Alors, let's agree that normally a phone, it's un téléphone. Of course, if you want to use the, I mean, to speak about the fact that it's un portable, it's totally possible. But let's agree that there are other types of phones. And so the basic translation would be un téléphone, okay? Un portable, it's okay, but it's in that case for a GSM or, a mobile phone. So don't forget the accent. If you've got the accent on your keyboard, un téléphone should be with accent aigu on the two first e. Okay, téléphone. So give me now a bed. What is a bed? Alors, un lit, of course, so it's masculine, and then you write it L-I-T, and it's in fact, it's quite funny, because it's the same form as the verb lire, when you conjugate it, that's in the third person of the singular, il, elle, lit, but then in that case, it's a substantive, it's a noun, and it's un lit. Allez, the last one, and it's a simple one too, it's so easy, a table. So as we agreed, it's really, really simple, and the table is obviously une table, as you can see. It's exactly the same way to write it. Remember that it's feminine. Table is a feminine word. So just to let you go, this will be really, really the last one, because this one was too simple, I guess, to finish. We'll finish with five verbs, and after that you're gone. To give. Alors, as I can see, you're fast and it's good. So to give, it's a regular verb from the first group and it's donné. So this one is usually quite simple to conjugate and it's not tricky. Je donne, tu donnes, il, elle donne. Nous donnons, vous donnez, il, elle donne. Could you please tell me what to take is? Alors, to take, it's prendre. Alors, prendre, it's a bit more complex because it's a verb from the third group. So, when it comes to the conjugation, it's je prends, tu prends, il, elle prend. So, DS for je prends, DS for tu, tu prends, D for il, elle. Then, nous prenons, only one N. Vous prenez, one N. And then, you double the N for the plural. Ils prennent. So, two N, elles prennent. And obviously, ENT in the end. Je prends, tu prends, il, elle prend, nous prenons, vous prenez, ils prennent, elles prennent. Could you please tell me what to have or to possess is in French? Alors, in that case, I wanted more to go with avoir, as most of you are writing. Ouria, you wanted to go for posséder. Be careful, it's not what you've been writing. Posséder sounds like coming from English, straight. So it's posséder. Posséder would be an option too. It's to possess. Sarah is writing posséder, and it's totally, totally possible here. Avoir, it's also the first and probably most used option to express this, to have and to possess. So what about this one, to call oneself, allez. So in that case, it's a pronominal verb, a reflexive verb. In that case, it's s'appeler. Remember, it should be with se. And then after that, you've got only one L. This is the tricky thing when you conjugate it. The infinitive is only with one L. But it's when you will conjugate it that the double L will come for je, tu, il, and elle. And then the plural il and elle, same thing, you will have to double the L. Je m'appelle, tu t'appelles, il s'appelle, elle s'appelle. Nous nous appelons, only one L here. Vous vous appelez, one L. And then il, elle s'appelle, you will double the L. And so the last one for today will be, well, this one. Allez. It's the last verb of the day, and it's allez. Apparently, Ice Cube, she's having some technical problems too. I'm not the only one. Yeah. So it was a special time because it was, I mean, normally we don't have this type of technical problems, but it does happen from time to time. So it was really nice. Thank you very much. I really hope that you enjoyed and you learned a few things, even if the stream was cut like that abruptly. So tomorrow it will be for advanced, so I will only speak French and we'll see other things. Merci beaucoup. Merci beaucoup. Au revoir et à bientôt.